In the last 3 years, I've done several cycles of creatine, and I can honestly say it does work. I've gained size, strength, and the ability to do more reps of certain exercises. We're going to show you these gains in a little bit, so stay tuned. Creatine was thought to cause
kidney damage,
but there's not much research to back that up.
There's several studies showing that creatine has no effect on kidney function in healthy people. One study found no changes in kidney function between college football players who supplemented with creatine and those who didn't for nearly 2 years. Another study showed no changes in kidney function for individuals consuming 10 grams of creatine a day for 12 weeks.
I don't think that last thing is enough to go by like some pure scientific proof of whether it does have an effect or not. 12 weeks isn't a whole lot of time. And I think in all our research that we've done, most of it says that there just hasn't been enough research to truly know the long-term effects of this. So just keep that in mind through this whole video.
Also, isn't taking 10 grams per day a lot?
Yeah, for the maintenance cycle, but for a preload cycle, they suggest 20 grams a day. For only, 5 to 7 days.
If you happen to have kidney issues, it is recommended not to take supplemental creatine. Just in case. Research has shown that creatine can increase urinary concentration, and urinary concentration can increase the development of kidney stones. And there's a link in the description for more information on that.
You ever had kidney stones?
No.
I knew a couple people that had kidney stones, and they say that they were big enough to see when they pissed it out into the toilet. And they said it freaking hurt.
Well, I would think it would.
One other safety issue is it's recommended you should be at least 18 years old to start taking supplemental creatine. Although other websites and our research says that there's been no scientific evidence that there was any side effects by taking it when you're young. I suspect that those articles probably came from the people that are selling the creatine or making it.
Well, yeah, like if you're under 18, they recommend you not to eat fish or red meat, right?
Really?
No, I was just joking. But I figure if you're like 13 and you're eating a lot of red meat and fish, then you're getting the same amount of creatine that normal people would be eating if they're taking supplemental creatine.
That's true. That's true.
Just some food for thought.
Yeah.
Side effects. Some people claim that creatine can cause dehydration, bloating, and stomach cramps.
Pussies.
However, to date, there have been no studies showing that creatine supplementation causes any of these issues.
One study that I read said that creatine is absorbed in the intestines, and some people, if it's not absorbed right away, can get irritated in their intestines, and maybe that's what people are talking about, stomach cramps. I've never experienced any of that, though. You?
Nope. Nothing that I've noticed.
Right.
I mean, I regularly have gas that I feel bloated from when I can't release the gas in public. And so if I felt any bloating, I would just have assumed that it was gas.
The one thing that I hear all the time is when you take creatine, you should take extra water. Drink more water. But I think that's a given anyway. If you drink enough water, which...
You don't.
I don't, but just recommend that you up your water intake, like with any kind of exercise, or just make sure you drink lots of water.
Ah, I feel better.
I'm not gonna.
Does creatine cause hair loss? If you don't already have male pattern baldness, then creatine is not going to affect you or cause you to lose your hair. But if you are prone to male pattern baldness, or if you're starting to already lose your hair, then creatine may accelerate that process. Because creatine does increase the levels of the androgenic hormone
dihydrotestosterone. You probably
heard. That's what I said.
DHT.
When large amounts of androgenic hormones are absorbed into the body, male pattern hair loss progresses at a much faster rate. Therefore, creatine can cause hair loss by increasing DHT levels.
What's DHT stand for?
Dihydrotestosterone. Studies show DHT levels increase by at least 15% when people take supplemental creatine. But again, if you don't already have a history of male pattern baldness, then creatine's not going to affect you or your hair falling out.
Did you just say pistory?
Nope.
Is that like the history of your urination?
And again, if you have a history of male pattern baldness, then maybe creatine's not going to be for you if you really like your hair or are trying to not lose the hair that's falling out of your head.
Fuck with my history, man. But our research shows that if you take 3 grams of creatine or less per day, it doesn't mess with your DHT levels. And the good thing is, In our tests, anyway, We've done 3 and even 2 grams of creatine a day and absolutely had great effects from it. So I'm pretty sure that means that even if you do have male pattern baldness and you take 2 or 3 grams a day and no more than that, it's not going to mess with your DHT levels and you're going to be good with your hair.
So play it safe and take less than 3 grams a day.
It works.
Bald guys, which kind? There's tons of different kinds of creatine out there. There's no data that proves any other kind of creatine works better than good old creatine monohydrate. Best to go with micronized creatine monohydrate if you can.
Yeah, the micronized, it's a lot finer. It's less sandy, it's like ground down even more, so it's gonna absorb in your intestines a lot better than the more granular stuff. For everything that I've taken different kinds of creatine, and in the end, it's always the same results. Our recommendation is take micronized creatine monohydrate, or if you know somebody that's taken some other formula, some newfangled formula, something like that, and they're having good results with it, why not try it? They always recommend that you take the highest grade creatine that you can get, and typically stuff from China isn't on that list. But I think there's a company in Germany or somewhere in Europe, CreaPure or something like that. It's highly recommended by a lot of the articles that I read. But to tell you the truth, I've tried 6-star creatine from Walmart. That was 10 bucks for a friggin' month supply, and it worked just as well as everybody else's. Whether it was adulterated with freaking cyanide or whatever, I can't tell you that, but I'm still alive and I had good results from it.
How much to take?
The general consensus is that the recommended dose of creatine is 3 to 5 grams a day. And I've done it at 2 grams a day, and then I've done a cycle at 5 grams a day. And for me, it didn't matter. I had the same gains whether I took 2 grams a day or 5 grams a day. A lot of companies recommend that you take a preload phase, meaning you take a lot more creatine up front in basically the first week to saturate your system with it, and then a maintenance cycle after that. And they recommend that the preload phase is 20 to 30 grams a day spread out throughout the day in 4 different doses and taking that for a week. And then after that, a maintenance phase of 3 to 5 grams a day. You might want to experiment with this and do a preload phase in one cycle and then not in the next one. I personally don't notice the difference between either one.
It's been reported that taking proteins in combination with carbohydrates can result in a greater increase in serum insulin concentrations that would be expected from the sum of their individual responses.
What that means is they discovered that if you take high concentrations of carbohydrates with creatine, that it increases the effects and makes it more, makes it more efficient to get into your system. But the amount of carbohydrates you would take wouldn't really be worth it, especially if you're trying to stay lean. So the jury is still kind of out on whether you would want to do that or not. Just going to gain weight if you're...
Is that like saying, like, if you take creatine with more carbohydrates, you'll be stronger at the gym? Like, yeah, because you're eating more carbohydrates.
Yeah, but they're saying, when you do that, they're saying upwards of 50 grams of carbohydrates, which is kind of a lot.
That's about a meal, if a good meal.
Right, so if you're doing that in combination with your meal, then you're just sort of just adding on more carbohydrates. So now what they're saying is a combination of a specific amount of carbohydrates combined with proteins, and I think they were saying 50 grams of each when you take the dose of creatine. That's optimum for the efficiency of the creatine, but...
Creatine works best when you use it and then go to the gym and push extra hard. What happens when you stop taking creatine?
The research suggests that you'll retain your strength, but you'll lose a little bit of size because some of the size is water weight in the muscles. It volumizes the muscles with a little bit of water. What I've noticed is I definitely lose the size. If I'm taking creatine and I gain a particular amount of size from it, like a half inch on my arms, then I stopped taking creatine. 6 weeks after I've stopped, I'm done. I'm back to where I was when I started. Now the strength gains, it's tough for me to say because if there's any strength difference between the two, I didn't notice the loss of it. I know people that take it and they, looking at them, they absolutely made the gains from it. And we talk about it and they say that's what the difference was. It was the creatine. And strength-wise, too, everybody that you talk to or that I talk to says that doing a few more reps of a particular weight and they're stronger. Also, a lot of people that I know that take it don't cycle it. They just keep taking it. Research does say that it's safe to continually do. You don't need to cycle it. You can just keep taking it forever. But again, we're not the scientists here, and other studies say that there's just more research needs to be done long term. Okay, so the results. Every time that I've done creatine, I've gained a half an inch on my arms. That, to me, that's what I measure most, and that's what I can see the most. And roughly anywhere from a half inch to 3/4 inch on my chest. Here's what happened. I started on July 1st, 2015.
Look at the guns. Try flexing.
Weight, 172 pounds. Right arm, 15 1/4 inches. Chest, 43 1/2 inches.
Randy only measured his right arm because he's a little embarrassed about the size of his left arm.
We measured again 3 weeks later on July 22nd, 2015. Weight, 173 pounds. I didn't work out on that day or the day before. Right arm, 15 3/4. And chest, 44.
On December 15, 2015, Randy measures a whopping 15 1/4 inches. Then again on January 26, 2016, and Randy gained just about a half inch with a measurement of 15 5/8. For his chest, his initial measurement was 42 3/4 inches. And then his measurement in January, he actually swelled up 1.5 inches on his chest with 44 1/4 inches.
Every time I take it, I get a half inch on my arms. After I stop taking it, I lose that half inch on my arms.
Seems like a waste of time.
If I keep taking it, I've no doubt that I would keep that half inch. We get a lot of questions. We get people saying, well, how do you know it was the creatine? It could have been this or that. The only difference was the creatine. I don't take any other supplements, and I've been working out for, say, 3 months solid, and then I start taking creatine. And we measure the results before and after, and it's a half inch difference. And we've done this at least 2 or 3 times with the same results. It's always a half inch bigger, and then I lose it after I stop taking it.
Yeah, ever since I knew you, you work out 1.5 times a week, every week, for years and years and years.
That's not too far from the truth, though. So it's, at least it's consistent. So you know that that's the effects that we got from the creatine. Creatine is just as good for women as it is for men.
Does it make their boobs bigger?
Ah, no, you're a big boob guy.
Big boob guy.
Big boob guy.
I'm a big boob guy. Where can I buy creatine?
If you want to buy it at Walmart for $10 for a cycle that would last you more than a month, you can do that. Is it from China? I don't know. Or you can go to a health store or a reputable supplement website and get something that's probably double or triple the price, but it's probably super high grade.
If you haven't done this already and you're really looking for creatine, type in creatine in Google, type in creatine in eBay and see what you get, or Amazon, look around.